Welcome back to this new inspirational video. Today I wanted to share with you how you can avoid lack of any kind. I'm sure you're interested in that, and perhaps you're familiar with this quotation from Emmett Fox. He said the following: "Lack of any kind is always traceable to the fact that we have been seeking our supply from some secondary source, instead of from God himself, the author and giver of life." There it is, in all its glory. If you understand this quote, you'll also understand why you never have to suffer lack of any kind. Of course, a lack might show up temporarily through what we perceive is going on in our physical lives, but it doesn't mean we have to stay there forever. That is the mistake that humanity makes everywhere around the globe. People see lack in their physical lives, and therefore they conclude that lack and limitations is part of their existence. Well, at times it may be, but it doesn't have to be a permanent part of your life. And the issue there is that most people are making it a permanent part of their lives. We don't want to do that. We want to understand this quote so that we can step away from that sort of lifestyle and really enjoy our time here on planet Earth. So, as he said, lack of any kind is always traceable to the fact that we have been seeking our supply from some secondary source instead of from God himself. Now, what are we thinking about when we use the term God? What exactly do we mean by that? Well, in my case, I think of God as the creative spirit behind all of creation. God being the creator, or as Emmett would say, the author and giver of life. It means our job, as the Bible said, be imitators of God as dear children, means we're going to have to become the author and giver of life to the good we desire. You're the author in the sense of you're going to decide what is the thing that you're going to manifest. What sort of lifestyle are you creating for yourself? You can write that story inside your consciousness, because basically it is a story that you made up for yourself. And you're also going to be the one that's going to give it life. Don't you like that? I always like that sort of ring to it. I'm going to give life to the dreams that I hold inside of my imagination. And I can do so because I was made in the image and likeness of God, based on the power that consciousness has. It's the same for you. You were made in the image and likeness of God. That means you have the power to create and give life to what you desire. And that is where you will realize that there is no lack of any kind. Every time you face a lack, physically speaking, all that we're called upon to do is to open our minds further and further to the solution to these problems. So we're going to create them inside of our consciousness first, and then it's going to be expressed in time, space, reality. So when I sit here, I go through my life. At times I might experience lack of some kind. I might be aware of that. I would like to have more of this or that, or I would like to feel a little more free in the way I'm living. What am I supposed to do in order to get to the place? Well, first of all, I'm going to have to understand that everything that is made by humans is created by their imagination. So therefore, anything that I want to have and experience has to be created through my imagination as well. Even though it might not seem obvious to most people at first, because they think of imagination as being used to invent stuff or to perhaps make music or write novels and make movies. That is true. It happens there at a very high frequency, on a very high level. But you can also create, through your imagination, a new source of income. You could create a better business for yourself, a better life. That's what we're after all the time. Life becomes mundane if it stays the same over and over again. So no matter how great your life is, odds are within a few years, or maybe faster, you will realize you'll have bigger and greater desires and dreams that you want to realize. That's what keeps life exciting. If you're already on the path where you're creating more and more success for yourself, you usually don't stop and think about this whole process. That's why many people are successful, but they can't tell you why they are, because they're just going along with it subconsciously. But by knowing how this whole process works, you're in a better position, because you can keep repeating it over and over again as much as you'd like. And also, if times get tough, you know where to look, which is inside your own mind. That's where God resides, inside of you. You are God in action all the time. So lack of any kind is traceable to the fact that we have been seeking our supply from some secondary source. With that, we mean you're looking at the physical world to confirm or deny that you can For example, have more, whatever that means. It doesn't necessarily have to mean money alone. It can be in many sorts of areas of your life. You're looking at the physical side of life for confirmation whether you can have more. More often than not, the physical side of life isn't even giving us any confirmation that there is more possible for us. But really think about it, throughout the ages, how did we reach this point with the humanity where we're no longer living in a cave outside in nature, even though some people still enjoy doing that, and more power to them because it can be way more peaceful than the stresses of city life and stuff like that, we won't deny that. But how did we get to this point where we're actually civilized humanity on the level it is now? It is because people realize that the power of creation lies within themselves. Humanity has discovered this, and usually it's only a small percentage of the population specifically that started to realize this, and they were the ones that made great advancement for all of mankind. They weren't just looking at the physical side of life the way it was and accepted it that way. They knew they weren't satisfied with how things were, so they wanted to create something greater. And in order to do so, they had to work together with God, even though they might not have realized that at the time, that they were working together with this spirit behind all of creation. That, to me, is the concept of the real God. And that's what you want to start working with for yourself. You face situations right now that you want to overcome. You don't overcome the situation by being completely obsessed with the issue at hand. You overcome a situation by expanding your mind in the direction of what you most desire. And you know, the desires, I always liked how Neville Goddard said it himself. Desires are the way that God is communicating with you about things that could be for you. That is absolutely beautiful, and that should give everyone hope. I always remind that point. It should give you hope. It should make you feel better about your life and existence. The fact that you have dreams and desires that you know would make your life so much better should give you hope, because it's God, the spirit behind all of creation, trying to, I would say the word tempt, maybe not necessarily tempting you, but trying to get you to believe in what could be for you. Every human being on the planet plays their own beautiful role in the part of all creation. You play your own unique role. There's nobody else like you on the planet. There's nobody else like me on the planet. Yes, we can be similar, but at the same time, in the very depths of our being, we all have our own role to play in the game of life. And that role is played based on the passions and desires you have. Everybody is growing in a different direction. And that is how it should be. But then we have this societal program in general going on where everybody wants to fit in, and therefore their uniqueness doesn't get a chance to shine, and they also don't really discover that power within them that can set them free from lack and limitation. That power being your oneness with God, your divine oneness with the spirit behind all of creation. You have the power to create. So now create. Don't make it complicated. We're not asking you to create a novel, unless that's what you desire to do. We're basically asking you to consider the word creating in a much broader scale than just for creative people specifically. You see, everybody is creative. You are creative right now. As I've said a year ago in one of my videos, the problem is that people are using their own creativity to create the limitations that they now complain about. Now that is absolutely huge to really grasp for yourself, because once you do, you'll never look at your life in the same manner. And that is very useful, therefore, because we don't want to stay stuck where we are. We want to grow where we want to be. We want to become one with our greatest desires in life. In order to do so, we have to stop looking at the physical side of life alone and assuming and asking that to give us what we desire. So every time I want to expand or achieve more in my world, I have to first establish a connection with what I desire within myself. With that I mean I have to find unity with the very thing I want to manifest. And as I do so, the ways for its realization are set in motion. And therefore I have come to the conclusion that my source of supply is infinite. And it's the same for you, because your mind can come up with an infinite ideas and ways on how to go about something. Perhaps there are limitations to that statement. I have yet to find them. But for most of our goals as human beings, your mind can come up with so many different ways on how to achieve the very thing you desire to achieve, that indeed your source of supply is infinite, because there's no lack of any kind because of your oneness with God. It is God all along. It inspires the way. As scriptures would say, his ways are past finding out. The ways to the realization of your goal are past finding out. You'll only become aware of them over time, or perhaps on reflection. Once you have achieved a dream, you can look back and see how it was done and then tell somebody else how you did it. But at first, it's very important for us to trust that we can do it, that we believe that we can do it. That is the foundation. If you believe that you have an infinite source of supply, then the universe will show you that that is true. How will it show you? Well, it's going to show you through all these inspired and unique ideas that flow into your consciousness, through which you know, if I were to act on these ideas, my life will change so dramatically and expand so drastically into a better direction that I can't deny some invisible force has my back. And that is true, that invisible force being God. Don't you like that? You have that connection with God, and all it's asked of you is to embrace that connection, become aware of it, and then have fun with it. You're allowed to have fun with this connection. You don't have to hold yourself back. You don't have to be a limited human being. You don't have to have lack of any kind, because lack of any kind is only, first of all, temporary, physically speaking, because you're here temporary. But then you also want to understand, this lack that I'm seeing, physically speaking, can be overcome by embracing more and more wealth and harmony, spiritually speaking. So always, we start with what we have, which is inside of our consciousness. That is the real mansion that we have to work from. We work from the kingdom of God and not from the kingdom of limitation. Let it sink in, because that is how you'll overcome lack of any kind in your world, by understanding that the lack you perceive can be overcome by expanding your mind in the direction of what you really want. So if it's a lack in money, then wealth could help you out. Financial money. Like, if you have lack of money, but wealth in the sense of more money could help you out. Now you have to start to believe that God will show you the way on how to earn more money. Trust in the process, and God will do his part of the job. He will inspire and compel you to go into a much greater direction with your life, through which you will earn that money. Yes, it might be a direction you haven't expected from the start. You may have not have thought about it at all before. It might be something totally new that you'll be compelled to do, but ultimately it's bringing you to that place of more wealth. This is another issue we might face, is that we have preconceived ideas on how something should go, and then because it's not going that way, we feel like we're failing or it doesn't work. Perhaps we're compelled to do something we haven't done before, and it might be a little uncomfortable and scary because it's beyond the comfort zone we had. But it's okay. It's still God trying to help you realize your greatest objectives in life. Because at the end of the day, God is the author and giver of life. And so can you become the author and giver of life to your greatest desires. Now, if you're new to this channel, consider subscribing to receive inspirational videos on a regular basis. And with that being said, dear viewer, never forget that we are the dreamers.